It's on.
Okay.
And I just wanted to remind you today that you are extremely beautiful.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
I just wanted to remind you guys that you are extremely beautiful.
You're very beautiful.
You're
very
sweet. You're welcome. You're very welcome. I just wanted to give you that reminder. Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. I'm Chanel. And unfortunately, Donovan is not here today. He's away for the weekend, but I was gonna do this video without him anyways, so kind of worked out. I'm just gonna say how nervous I am to be doing this video today. I am not a person who likes to share my opinions or feelings with family or friends, and definitely not over the internet. Yeah. All in all, I'm just very nervous, but I know that I should do it. And I actually recently on Instagram posted about this topic, so I will link it down below for you guys to go read it if you want. You're going to be looking for a picture like this. There you go. You can't really see it, it's blurry. But you get the point. Honestly, I'm just gonna basically be going over everything that I talked about on there, just a little bit more in depth with certain things. And since I'm going to be talking a lot, I just realized I should probably grab some tea, so I will be right back. Alright, so today's topic is basically just body image and believing that you're beautiful. When I posted this on Instagram, I was sitting there at my house on the couch and I was just listing off everything that I hated about myself. As I was realizing that I was doing that and realizing that I was listening to that little voice inside my head, I was like, I know this is not who I am, but for whatever reason, I'm being so negative towards myself. And so I just got so fed up, so tired of that little voice over and over again, tearing me down into believing that I'm not good enough, that I'm not beautiful enough, and not capable. And I remember when I went to YWAM, which if you guys don't know what that is, there's a video called Our Story on our YouTube channel that kind of explains it a little bit more. But when I went to YWAM, I remembered how important and how powerful it is to speak things out. If you hang around with negative people, you're gonna be more negative. If you hang around with positive people, you're gonna be more positive. If you say negative things, you're gonna be more negative. If you say positive things, you're gonna be more positive. And so forth. So while I was there, there were so many girls that were kind of like walking through the same thing I was and just on the journey of trying to believe that we are truly beautiful exactly the way that we are. And so a lot of it was just like speaking out truths and replacing lies with truths. So yeah, that day when I was sitting there and posted on Instagram, one, I just felt like it. I felt it really heavy on my heart that other girls needed to hear this message as well, and that's also part of the reason why I'm making this today, is I really feel that there's somebody watching that needs to hear this and needs to believe that they are beautiful. And I know that when I say, like, you need to believe that you're beautiful, that there are so many girls watching that don't believe me, who truly think that they are not beautiful. And that actually breaks my heart a little bit, because you are all so beautiful. And I know it's hard, especially in the society that we live in, how there's this one ideal body, this one ideal person that we want to be like. But the reality of it is that we can't all be the same. We are all so different. And instead of thinking about what we want, we need to start looking about what we have, and we need to start loving our bodies and just realizing that we're all different for a reason. You're so, so beautiful. And so loved. Honestly, for me, what I need to believe at the end of the day is the truth about what God says about me. I need to believe that I am beautiful exactly the way that I am. And you need to believe that you're beautiful exactly the way that you are. And I know that there's some girls that are watching this, that are sitting on their bed, sitting on their couch, getting ready, whatever, that are thinking, no, I'm really not. Or like something in you is just like, ugh. I don't want to even hear this. I don't want to even accept it because I'm not. You are beautiful. It's just not fair for you to believe anything but that. And I totally get it because I've been there. And I've been in a place of just feeling worthless and feeling like there's nothing that I can do that can make me beautiful. And the truth is, you are enough. That you are so beautiful. and that you are so capable of anything you put your mind to. And I'm gonna constantly be saying these things over and over and over again because I want you to understand it and I want you to get it. If there's anybody out there that like truly doesn't believe it, I hope that you continue watching, that you can leave this video feeling, if not more beautiful, at least encouraged, and knowing that there can be an end to this little voice. And so yeah, over the years, God's kind of shown me that no relationship, no perfect Instagram post or any compliment that I'll ever get will be a lasting solution. Honestly, soon as those highs fade, soon as that relationship's over or whatever, you are right back. I was right back in the place of just not feeling enough, not feeling beautiful, and searching for another way to feel adequate, whether that was another relationship or another outrageous Instagram post. It just wasn't anything that was lasting. That was definitely more like when I was in high school. Now I am in a very beautiful, committed, loving relationship with my husband, Donovan. My life has definitely changed, and I honestly don't think that Donovan will ever understand how much I appreciate everything that he does for me and for the amount of times that he calls me beautiful. It's funny because it's usually when I'm being like the weirdest human ever and running around being a freak, or like I've just rolled out of bed or something, and he always gives me this certain like little smile, and I'm always like, what? And he either says like, you are so beautiful, or I just love you so much. It's cheesy, I know, but every single time he does that, it's a little reminder of like just how in love he is with me. In my weirdness, in my silliness, in my awkwardness, in my I've just rolled out of bed look, he loves me for exactly who I am. And honestly, girls, find a man like that. Find a man that doesn't love you despite of those weird things, but loves you because of them. As much as that's part of Donovan's job as my husband, at the end of the day, as much as those superficial things, he won't be able to fill this hole inside me. We are two imperfect people, and we cannot make each other perfect. We cannot complete each other. If you're getting into a marriage relationship and thinking all my problems are gonna disappear, like it's gonna be perfect, that's false. Your problems are not gonna go away. Whatever you're dealing with before you get married, it's gonna be the same. The only bonus of it is that you actually get a partner to do it with. You get somebody to walk through these things with you and to help you. It is definitely a beautiful journey. And so I learned that as much as Donovan helps me believe that I'm beautiful, for me, the only thing that is lasting, the only thing that is eternal, the only thing that will forever be constant and forever be the same is what God tells me. And just a simple but so powerful truth of that I am beautiful exactly the way that I am. And I am created perfect. But anyways, today I just wanted to remind you, all of you beautiful girls out there, that you are enough, that you are beautiful, that you are worthy, that you are loved, and that you are capable of anything you set your mind to. Also, us women, we are not in competition with each other. We really should be standing together, lifting each other up, instead of being jealous that the girl over there has perfect hair and you want it. So I'd go over and say, girl, I love your hair. And I guarantee you, if it doesn't make that person's day, it's at least gonna make them smile. You can overtake that voice inside your head, because that is not the truth of who you are. That is not the truth of who you're made to be and what you're supposed to conquer in this world and what you're supposed to do. So if you continue watching for this next clip, at the end of this video, I will give you some things to combat those little voices. I did them for 5 months and honestly, it changed my world. But until then, I have a short little clip of something that I did while I was thinking of this video. It popped into my head, and I know it's been done before. The girl that did it, her name is Shay, and she did it for a school project, but it would be a perfect way to kind of end this video. So keep watching.
So it's on.
Okay.
And I just wanted to remind you today that you are extremely beautiful.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
I just wanted to remind you guys that you are extremely beautiful.
You're very sweet.
You're
very sweet.
You're welcome. You're very welcome. I just wanted to give you that reminder. I'm beautiful.
Aww.
You guys both had the cutest face.
You're disgusting. Oh, you're so sweet. I love you so much.
Clip as much as I did. It was extremely fun and extremely nerve-wracking, but I'm so glad that I did it because there's just so many smiles and so many thank yous. To end this off, I want to give you three things to kind of combat those negative feelings towards yourself and to get you on the journey of truly believing that you're beautiful. So one, which also these are pretty weird, but I promise they will work. Or at least help. I want to start a 30-day challenge for all you lovely ladies out there. At some point in the day, stand in front of the mirror, because honestly, I think that a mirror can be our worst enemies, because we stand in front of them and we pick out all these negative things. And so look in the mirror, say out loud something that you love about yourself. Even if you don't, say the opposite. Say if you're looking at yourself and you're thinking, I hate my stomach. Instead, whether you believe it or not, start rerouting your brain and saying, I love my stomach, because I promise you that it will start to change the way that you look at yourself. It'll start to make you more positive because you're saying positive things. And second, sounds super weird, and it is super weird, but maybe it'll work for you, I don't know, at least try one of them, is when a negative thought comes in your head, just crumple that up and throw it behind you. Crumple it up, throw it behind you. If one thing comes out, crumple that up, throw it behind you. You know what I'm saying? Doing something physical. Just get it small and throw it. Something physical to be like, I am not going to think about this. I'm not going to think about it. So yeah, and the third one is just the fact that you are beautiful. That you are truly, truly beautiful exactly the way that you are. And I hope that you leave this believing that. And if not believing that, at least feeling encouraged and being in a place realizing that you don't have to feel this way forever, and that you can get to a place of really truly believing day in and day out you are beautiful and you don't have to change a thing about yourself. I hope you guys have a great weekend, and I will see you next week.